morning all of you. Today I will again discuss next topic of mathematical induction. As you know that in the previous class I have discussed some basic definition terms and some simple examples which is related to mathematical induction. But in this video I will mainly solve the standard level of problems with main concept of mathematical induction. In the previous class, we do not discuss the main concept of mathematical induction. We simply define some examples. That means the part of a mathematical induction. Now, we understand what do you mean by mathematical induction. As you know that, in the previous classes, I have discussed inductive set. What do you mean by inductive set? So, firstly, I want to define inductive set. A set S is said to be inductive set class 11th. A set S is said to be inductive set if X belongs to S, 1 belongs to S, then 1 plus X also belongs to S. That is, a set S is said to be inductive set. S जो आपका inductive set कहलाता है. अगर आप 1 और x, that means मैंने मान लिया कि 1 आपका इसका एलिमेंट है, 1 belongs to s, and suppose x belongs to s, then 1 plus x also belongs to s, then in that case given set is called inductive set. तो inductive set का आपका एक definition होता है. चलिए इसके बाद inductive set को अगर समझ लेते तो important बात और भी लिख लीजिएगा. Natural number, that means set of natural number is at smallest set of inductive set. Inductive set का जो है ना सबसे छोटा set है. Inductive set मतलब smallest set of inductive set, जो भी आपका smallest set of inductive set, inductive set का सबसे छोटा set जो होता है आपका natural number होता है. मतलब real number का जो subset होगा natural number, it is smallest set of inductive set. Inductive set का सबसे छोटा set यही आता है. चलिए अब हम लोग चलते हैं डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैथमेटिकल इंडक्शन. प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैथमेटिकल इंडक्शन, मैथमेटिकल इंडक्शन फर्स्टली आई वांट टू डिफाइन व्हाट यू मीन बाय मैथमेटिकल इंडक्शन एंड व्हाट इज द मेन प्रोसीजर टू प्रूफ ऑल दोज मैथमेटिकल आइडेंटिटी इन प्रॉपर सेट, दैट मींस इन द इंडक्टिव सेट. Principle of mathematical induction. Let P and B a mathematical statement involving the set of natural number. Then Pn is true for all, it is read as for all. Then Pn is for all number. And if then Pn is for all numbers and then Pn is true for all numbers and if P1 is true in second point, Pm plus 1 is true if Pm is true. That is, in the previous classes I have discussed similar condition. That is, mathematical induction simply says that if Pn is a mathematical statement which is defined only for natural number, and P1 is true, if it is it defines for natural number, in that case definitely true for then in that case definitely it becomes true for P1, that means n is equal to 1. In the second point, suppose that if Pm is true, because Pn is true for all natural number, Then we suppose it is also true for M, PM. It is M, not M. You have to careful on it. PM. Firstly, I will check, is it true for P1? According to definition, mathematical induction is a statement, mathematical, PNB is a mathematical statement involving the set of natural numbers. That means it satisfies for all natural number. If it is true for and is equal to one natural number, by supposing PM is also true, PM plus 1 is also true if PM is true. So first of all, we have to check out, if you take some procedures of solving the mathematical induction problem, first of all, we have to check out, is it true for P1? If for n is equal to 1, Pn is true, then we have to suppose Pm is also true. Then we have to suppose Pm is also true. Then with the help of P1 and Pm, we have to again show that Pm plus 1 is also true for m belongs to natural number. I think I will again repeat it for best understanding. Firstly, as you know that mathematical induction means that let us Pn is a mathematical statement and Pn is true for n is equal to natural number. Pn is true for any n belongs to natural number. Then it definitely satisfies P1 because n is equal to 1 is a natural number. If it satisfies P1, then we have to suppose it. Pm is also true, where m belongs to natural number. If Pm is true, then you have to show that Pm plus 1 is also true with the help of Pm and P1. Now we take some examples, then you will definitely understand it. First of all, we take some simplest problem. As you know that sum of n natural number is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. Can you prove it? And I think you have already studied in the class 10th in the arithmetic progression. You can add so simple 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot 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 n is equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2. But does there exist any other process by which you can show Pn, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot 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 n, where n belongs to natural number, is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2? Write some problems. Prove by mathematical induction that the sum of first n odd natural number is n square. There is a given problem. Prove by mathematical induction, I write mathematical induction that the sum of natural number, sum of n odd natural number is n square. You have to show that using mathematical induction, sum of n odd natural number is n square. How can you prove it? Let Pn is equal to, what is the meaning of sum of n natural number? Firstly, I want to write it. Let Pn is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot and dot plus 2n minus 1. Because it is an odd natural number and the standard form of natural number will be 2n minus 1. 2n minus 1. So, I take an odd natural number 2n minus 1. Because why do we take 2n minus 1, if you put n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, dot dot dot, you will get continuously all odd natural numbers. So you have to first of all also know what is the standard form of given set as here odd natural number. Odd natural number 2n minus 1. Now, after writing the mathematical statement, as I have said in mathematical induction, as you know that Pn is true for all natural number, then you have to check out at 1, n is equal to 1. Now, take n is equal to 1, is equal to n square, given that. Now, take n is equal to 1. If you put in LHS and RHS, you get n is equal to 1 means that what does represent n? N represents number of terms. N represents number of terms. But 2n minus 1, what does it represent? An nth term of this sequence of terms. So take n is equal to 1. If we take n is equal to 1, n is equal to 1, here you know that n represents number of terms. So after putting the number of terms, you get definitely only one number of terms. So you get 1. And if you put it in the right words, you get 1 square. That will be 1 is equal to 1. So you can say that P1 is true. P1 is true. Because if you put the value of n is equal to 1, you get LHS and RHS. Both will be the same. So you can say that P1 is true. Now, you have to suppose that let Pm is also 2. Let Pm is also 2. If Pm is true, then you can say that Pm is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot 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 plus 2n minus 1. That will be m square definitely. According to given condition, as you know that Pn is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot dot 2n minus 1 is equal to n square. So, by supposing n is replaced by m, you can say that if Pm is true, then definitely Pm is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot dot 2m minus 1 is equal to m square. Then, you have to show that if P1 is true, Pm is true, then Pm plus 1 is also true. Now, again, you have to show that Pm plus 1 is also 2. Then again, we have to show that Pm plus 1 is also 2. How can you show that? Using Pm and P1. With the help of Pm, you have to show that Pm plus 1 is also 2. If you suppose true for m belongs to natural number, this mathematical statement, then it will be definitely true. If it is not true, then it will be not correct. Now, firstly you have to write it. Now, we write it in expansion form. You can write Pm plus 1 means that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus dot 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 2m minus 1. Here represents up to Pm. After it, you have to also write m plus 1. Now, number of m plus 1 terms, what does it mean? You have to simply, now you have to write next term. How can you write? Simply m is replaced by m plus 1. If you replace m by m plus 1, you get 2 times 2 times m plus 1 minus 1. Now you can write 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus dot 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 plus 2m minus 1 plus, after multiplying, simplifying, you get 2m plus 1. As you know that up to 2m minus 1 term, you know that its value will be m square. According to supposing a statement, you have already supposed 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus dot dot 2m minus 1 will be m square. After adding 2m plus 1 in the m square, what do we get? M square plus 2m plus 1. That will be m plus 1 whole square. You can see that. Now, what do we get? And where you have to reach? First of all, you have to also consider where you have to reach. I have to reach Pm. If Pm is true, then Pm is equal to m square. What does it represent? Simply mm. If you put at m, m plus 1, what do we get? What shall I get? M plus 1 whole square. According to given mathematical induction, that means m square, if you put at the value of m plus 1, you get m replaced by m plus 1. M is replaced by m plus 1. So, in RHS, you can also m replaced by m plus 1. That means you have to get this statement. According to question, if you finally you get pm plus 1 is equal to m plus 1. So, pn is also true for m plus 1 proof. I think you can understand the whole process. You have to only consider at the final stage, after writing up to 12 minus 1, you have to simply write next term. And how can you write next term after n terms or after m terms? Simply, you have to replace m by m plus 1. Then you get definitely up to m plus 1 terms. After getting up to m plus 1 term, you know that up to m minus 1, sum of up to m terms, you get m square, and simply add to m plus 1, after you get m plus 1 whole square. And you have to also consider about given statement, as you know that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus dot 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 n, that means n is 2 n minus 1, you get n square. After it, I have done some mistakes in each problem, you have to correct them, here it doesn't say natural number. I have written in each part natural number. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. Sorry. I think solution of this problem is over. Now, I take next problem. In the next problem, it says that prove by mathematical induction. Example 2, proof by mathematical induction. 1 plus 5 plus 9 plus 4n minus 3 plus 4n minus 3 is equal to n into 2n minus 1, n into 2n minus 1 for all natural belongs to, for all n belongs to natural number. You have to show that sum of 1 plus 5 plus 9 plus dot dot 4 minus 3. You have to show that its sum will be n into 2 minus 1 using mathematical induction, not a arithmetic progression. As you know that from this sum of n terms, 1 plus 5 plus 9, it can be proved by arithmetic progression, but you have not care on it. Firstly, I want to prove it by mathematical induction. Let Pn is equal to 1 plus 5 plus 9 plus dot 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 4n minus 3. According to question, it will be 2n into 2n minus 1. Now, firstly, I want to check, is it correct for n is equal to 1? If you put n is equal to 1, here what is representation? Here n represents number of terms. You have to be careful in each case. If you take here n means 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, plus dot dot n terms. So here, if you take n is equal to 1, firstly, take n is equal to 1. If you take n is equal to 1 towards LHS, P1 is equal to 1 in LHS. In RHS, if you put n is equal to 1, 2 times 1 minus 1, that will be 1 times 2 minus 1, that means 1, that will be 1. That is, you can say that Pn is true for n is equal to 1. So, in other words, Pn is equal to P1. Pn is true for n is equal to 1. That is, P1 is 2.
P1 is true. If P1 is true, then you have to suppose falsely PM is also true.
Let PM is also true. What do you have to prove? Well, sorry. What do you have to firstly suppose? Suppose, that means let PM is also true for M belongs to natural number. If PM is true, then PM is equal to 1 plus 5 plus 9 plus dot 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 plus 4M minus 3. Simply M, N is replaced by M, that means M times 2M minus 1. You can write it as, if PN is true for N is equal to M, then you get this expression. What can you say about it? Now, we have to prove PM plus 1 is also true. अब हमें प्रूफ करना है कि PM plus 1 भी true है. अगर PM true है, तो मुझे प्रूफ करना है कि PM plus 1 भी true है. Now, how can we prove it? Firstly, write given mathematical induction up to M plus 1 terms. After it, you have to remember it. 1 plus 5 plus L plus dot dot for M minus 3 is equal to M times 2M minus 1. Because I have to use it. Now, we have to prove PM plus 1 is also true. So, you can write PM plus 1 is equal to 1 plus 5 plus N plus dot 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 4M minus 3. What is it? It is a mth term. It is mth term. That means number of terms will be M. Then you can write it. But here, number of terms will be M plus 1. That means you have to go again, write next term. How can you write after mth term, that means m plus 1 terms, simply m is replaced by m plus 1, then you can write 4 times m plus 1 minus 3, if you replace m by m plus 1. So you can write it 1 plus 5 plus 9 plus dot 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 4m minus 3 dot. Now you have to multiply, you get 4m plus 1. Now you have to consider also another point where you have to reach. You have to reach at the point. Now, firstly, you have to also consider during solving problem after adding a whole expansion where you have to reach, you have to also consider for it. First of all, you have to consider where do we have to reach. I have to arrive at M plus U. This statement, that means PL is also true for N, M is equal to M plus 1. That means if you replace N by M plus 1, then you get a final expression of this final expression, that means final sum of whole terms. It is very simple clue, because if you know already, then so you then you can easily reach at the point, that means final result. So I want to say where you have to reach. Sometimes you maybe that creates problem for reaching final answer, then you can directly reach by writing this term. How can you write? Simply, N is replaced by M plus 1. That means, enough you have to write. Not in this line. M plus 1, that means 2 times M plus 1 minus 1. You have to reach in this expression. You have to reach at this expression. How can you reach at that point? Firstly, you have to show, as you know that, up to M plus 1, up to M term, sum of whole expansion will be M times 2m minus 1. M times 2m minus 1. Now you have to add again in it 4m plus 1. Now you have to add 2m square minus 2m. 2m square minus m plus 4m plus 1. That will be 2m square. 2m square plus 3m plus 1. After splitting its middle term, you can write it as 2m square plus 2m plus m plus 1. So you can write it as, be careful, you have to reach at that point. After taking common 2m plus 1, 2m, you get m plus 1. Plus taking common 1, you get m plus 1. Is equal to, if you take common on both terms, m plus 1, you get 2m plus 1. You get 2m plus 1. You have got m plus 1 into 2m plus 1. But you have to reach at that point. M plus 1 into 2m plus 1 plus 1 minus 1. According to this problem, if you consider about both expression, both will be same. Both will be same. Because you can write m plus 1 into 2m plus 1. If you multiply whole expansion 2m plus 2 minus 1, 2m plus 2 minus 1 plus 1. So you can write 2m plus 1. That is m plus 1 into 2m plus 1. I think you have reached it at final answer. So, you don't forget to write this statement. So, it is also, that means Pn is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. That is, Pn is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. Now, you have to take next problem of this exercise. Example 2. Now we take example 3. In this method, there are many problems. Sometimes there are many mathematical equations or mathematical identity that becomes very tough, very complex its proof. Then you can proceed using mathematical induction. As you know that 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, that means sum of a square of n natural number. Sum of cube of n natural number is equal to n into n plus 1 by divide n into n plus n sum of a square of n natural number is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. And sum of cube of n natural number is equal to n into n plus 2 n into n plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. How can you prove this expression? There are many processes, but in which one of the most famous processes that will be mathematical induction. Using mathematical induction, you can prove it so easily without creating any problems. So you can reach at the final result. So you can use this problem anywhere to prove any mathematical equation that satisfies for and belongs to natural number. That is, we have to show that using mathematical induction, 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus n into n plus 1 is equal to n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 into 3. Using mathematical induction, as you know that in this method, first of all, we have to take let Pn is equal to given statement 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into plus 4 plus dot 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 n times n plus 1. That will be n times n plus 1 into n plus 2 divided by 3 as according to given condition. Now, at n is equal to 1, that is P1 is equal to n represents number of terms. So if you take n is equal to 1, then you have to take LHS of this part only single term, that means 1 into 2 is equal to. Now you have to put the value of n is equal to 1 in the given statement. After it, you have to observe is it correct or not. If it is correct, then you have to further proceed its next process, that means 1 times 3, cancel 1 into 1, 2, that will be 2. Here you observe that this mathematical statement is true for n is equal to 1. If it is true for n is equal to n, then you have to suppose it is also true for n is equal to n. Suppose it is true for n is equal to m also. It is also true for n is equal to m also. In that case, you can say that Pm is equal to 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus dot 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 m times m plus 1. that will be m into m plus 1 into m plus 2 divided by 3. You can write it as, if it is true for m and is equal to m, then you have to show that, then we have to show that, where you have to show that it is also true for pm plus 1, that is, it is also true for pm plus 1 for m n is equal to m plus 1, that is pm plus 2. That is, you have to show that it is also true for n is equal to m plus 1, that is m plus 1. Before writing it, you have to also remember it up to m terms. That means, suppose this equation is taken as first. With the help of equation first, you have to show that sum of m plus 1 terms also true according as this mathematical statement. Now, firstly, I want to write up to m plus 1 term. If we write up to m plus 1 terms, you get pm plus 1. That will be 1 times 2 plus 2 times 3 plus 3 times 4 plus dot dot. Firstly, you have to write up to m terms. After m term, you get m plus 1 term. So you have to also write m into m plus 1, that represents m term, plus after m term you have to write m plus 1 term. What do you mean by m plus 1 term? That means in the general term it represents n term, in nth term n is replaced by simply m plus 1, that is m plus 1, n is replaced by m plus 1. Here you have to also replace n by m plus 1. N is replaced by m plus 1 and plus 1. That is equal to 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus dot 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 m times m plus 1 plus m plus 1 times m plus 2. Is it also true? It is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. Now we have to think that where you have to reach. Firstly, you have to put n is equal to m plus 1 in this expression, in a rough part. M plus 1, n is replaced by m plus 1. M plus 1, that means m plus 2. N is replaced by m plus 1, that means m plus 3. Divided by 3. That is, after calculating these terms, you have to get this value. That is, now you have to be careful and you have to reach at that point. Sometimes, as I know that, sometimes there may be you can't reach at that point. You can, in that case, you can reach directly that point. That means, after writing one or two steps, you can write directly this line. But it is not correct style. But in that case, when you face trouble or any problems, then you can write it directly. But I have to go by process. As you know that up to m plus up to m term, sum will be from equation first. You can write m times m plus 1 into m plus 2 divided by 3 plus m plus 1 into m plus 2. Now you have to add it. Now you can write m plus 1 into m plus 2 after taking common. M plus 1 into m plus 2, you get m by 3 plus 1. After adding, you get m plus 1 into m plus 2 into m plus 3 divided by 3. You can add 3 in whole terms. Now, if you want to arrange it as like it, you can write. That means you have to replace n by m plus 1. I have written directly. That is, before it, you can write m plus 1 into m plus 1 plus 1 into m plus 1 plus 2. Divided by 3. Its sum will be in terms, because n is simply replaced by m plus 1. That is m plus 1, m plus 1. M plus 1, m plus 1, m plus 1, m plus 1. Now you can write it as m plus 1 plus 1 m plus 1 plus 2. Now you have reached at this point. You have to show that here I have forgotten an important point. You have to write after writing this term, you can write this statement. It's right one. You have to write this part x right one, and you have to again proceed towards LHS, reach at the point. आपको सिंपली इसके एलएचएस पार्ट से बढ़ करके इस पॉइंट तक पहुंचना है, ठीक। और ये पार्ट आप लोग यहाँ पर राइट में लिख दीजिएगा, यहाँ पर स्पेस नहीं, इसलिए हम उस प्रॉब्लम में भी नहीं लिखा था, आप लोग यहाँ पे लिख सकते हैं, ठीक। आई थिंक यू अंडरस्टैंड आवर फैक्ट। नाउ आई टेक नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल। द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इट सेज दैट यू हैव टू शो दैट 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 n square is equal to n into n plus 1 into 12 plus 1 divided by 6. Firstly, I want to see your problem. Yeah. Prove by mathematical induction 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 n square is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Yeah, so that. Now, we proceed towards solving problem. Firstly, let Pn is equal to 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 n square. That represents n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. You can write it as, let it is true, Pn is true, dot suppose simply at n is equal to 1. What does represent n is equal to 1? It simply represents the number of terms. If you take n is equal to 1, then according to given condition, you have to take simply first term, that means only single term, towards LHS of given mathematical induction, that means 1 square is equal to. Now you have to put n is equal to 1 towards the right side. That helps to understand the number of first term will be its sum. That means here sum of one terms means that single term, right one, you have to put the n is equal to 1, and if you get same value on both sides, then you can say that Pn is true for n is equal to 1. Now you put n is equal to 1, then you get 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2 times 1 plus 1, that divided by 6, that implies that 1 square, that will be 1 into 2 into 3, that will be divided by 6, finally you can write it as 1. That is, you can say that Pn is true for n is equal to 1. So, you can say that Pn is true for n is equal to 1. If Pn is true for n is equal to 1, then you have to suppose, let Pn is also true. Pn is also true for n is equal to n belongs to natural number, that is Pm. That is, you have to show that is, suppose that Pn is true for Pn is true for n is equal to m also, when n belongs to natural number, that is Pm is true. Now we have to show that Pm plus 1 is also true. What do you mean by Pm plus 1? Pm plus 1 means that n is simply replaced in the given statement, mathematical statement m plus 1. That means you can write it, n is replaced by m plus 1. After putting in second part m plus 1 plus 1, that means m, you can write in two terms m plus 1 plus 1. And now you have to put here 2 times m plus 1 plus 1 divided by 6. That means you have to show that Pm plus 1 is equal to m plus 1 times m plus 1 plus 1 into 2 times m plus 1 divided by 6. Now you have to proceed towards LHS of our supposing mathematical statement. Firstly, rub it. Now as you know that Pm plus 1, its LHS will be 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 m square. Firstly, you have to write up to m terms. After m terms, you have to write m plus 1 term with the help of general term of given sequence. As you know that in this sequence, n term will be n square. What represents it? It represents n term. Sometimes in your class level, there is not given, there is always given n term. But sometimes there is not given n term, then you have to conclude. Then you have to conclude or by observation, you have to write now n term. After it, you have to proceed. But in the eighth problem, in your book, n term is given. N term is given. So you can write m plus 1 term simply and is replaced by m plus 1. That is m square plus m plus 1 terms. Now, you have to reach at which point I have written already here. So you have to remember it where you have to reach. After it, you can so easily reach at that point. As you know that 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus m square is equal to m times m plus 1 times 2m plus 1 divided by 6 plus m plus 1 whole square. After taking common on both term m plus 1, you can write m times 2m plus 1 divided by 6 plus m plus 1. After simplifying, you get m plus 1 times 2m square plus m plus 6 m plus 6 divided by m plus 1. I have taken LCM denominator of both term. Now you can write it as m plus 1 times 2m square plus 7m plus 6 divided by 6. Now I have to write it. Firstly, I want to rub above part of this problem. You can write m plus 1 times 2m square plus 7m plus 6. If you split its middle term, you get 2m square plus 4m plus 3m plus 6 divided by 6. Now you can write m plus 1 into 2m, taking common on after arranging in pair, you take firstly common 2m on first two terms and after it in second two terms. If you take 2m common from first two terms, you get 2m into m plus 2 plus if you take common 3 in next two terms, you get 3 times m plus 2 divided by 6. So you can write it as m plus 1 times 2m plus 3 times m plus 2 divided by 6. Now you have to also again careful m plus 1 times m plus 2 times 2m plus 3 divided by 6. If you observe your written at this part of m plus 1 which has already written by me here at that place in earlier. Now rub it and try to proceed at that point m plus 1, m plus 2. Remember it. What do we write here? M plus 1 into m plus 2 into 2 into m plus 1, 2 into m plus 1 plus 1 divided by 6. You can consider which is equal to RHS. So you can say that PN is also true for M plus 1. That is PM plus 1 is also true. Sorry, that is PN is also true for N is equal to M plus 1. Simply you can write it proof. That is, if you satisfy for Pn is equal to Pn is true for n is equal to m plus 1, directly you can write proof. Or you can say in other words, Pn is also true. Or Pn is true for all n belongs to natural number. Now we write next problem 4. I want to firstly help you by different by solving different problems such that you can solve exercise or other examples. Firstly, I choose some important problems that helps to understand another problem. Firstly, we take next problem 5. I think it is also so simple. Further, I want to proof it. Proof by mathematical induction. 1 cube. Sorry, 1 square, 3 square. I think you have. You can proof it, but 1 square, 3 square, 5 square plus dot 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 up to n times is equal to n times 4n² - 1, n times 4n² - 1 divided by 3. You have to show that for all n belongs to natural number. You have to show that. How can you show? Simply. Let Pn is equal to 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square. Dot dot dot. It is very interesting problem because there is not given n terms. There is not given n terms. How can you write n terms? It is very common terms. A common fact. Firstly, I want to learn you. How can you write n terms of given sequence? As you know that in the arithmetic process, arithmetic progression, but in each case there does not exist given sequence in arithmetic process, arithmetic progression. There comes many you can face many problems as like it simply follow another rule. But if you care on it, you can say that n terms, next term again. How do we get next term? You can say that simply odd term. Odd term. What is the standard form of odd term? 12 - 1. So you can write 12 - 1. Before writing this term, it becomes very crucial for you. So you have to definitely write n term of given sequence. After it, you can show. Because you have to again, when you solve next step of this problem, you have taken n is equal to n. In case of pm plus 1, you replace n by m plus 1. How do you replace m? How can you get n term? How can you get n plus 1 term? That means definitely firstly you have to write n term, after it n is replacing by m plus 1, you can write m plus 1 term. So you have to remember it. If in that given sequence there is not given n term, by observing or using general algebra, you have to write n term. After it you can show similar way. As I have firstly written n term, when I have written n term, 1 square, 3 square plus 5 square plus dot dot 12 - 1 is equal to, you have to show that n times 4n² - 1 divided by 3. 4n² - 1 divided by 3. Now, I want to say you, what does it represent? As you know that, what does it represent n is equal to 1? It represents number of term that satisfy given on both sides. That means n is equal to 1, if you put LHS of LHS and RHS, if you put n is equal to 1 towards LHS, what does it represent? It represents you have to take only one term. You have to take only single term. While towards RHS, it represents sum of first term. There you can say that I think you know that in the problem there is not given sum of first term. It is a nonsense meaning. But if you try to understand it, you can. If you have to given 2 + 3 = 4, 2 + 3 = 4 + 4, 2 + 3 + 4 + 5. Here you can say that sum of 4 terms, sum of 3 terms, sum of 2 terms. It may be sum of single terms. That means simply that term. So you can write a sum of n terms, that means p1. That will be simply one term, that will be 1. And if you put towards the right side, you get n times n is equal to 1 into 4 times 1² - 1 divided by 3. That will be 3 divided by 3, that means 1. So you can say that, and if for n is equal to 1, pn is 2.
So you can say that it is true. P1 is true. That is, Pn is true for n is equal to 1. Now you have to suppose, now let Pm is also true. Now let Pm is true. Now Pm is true. That means Pm, you can say that Pn is true for n is equal to 1. It becomes more attractive. Let Pn is true for n is equal to m. If you put n is equal to m, then you can write 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square plus dot 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 2m minus 1 whole square is equal to m into 4m minus 4m square minus 1 divided by 3. You have to suppose it equation first. If this mathematical statement is true, then it is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. So now, so it is also true. Now it is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. You have to show that. Now you have to show that Pn is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. Now I think, how can you show that if Pn is also true for n is equal to m plus 1, then you have to simply replace, that means add in LHS n is equal to m plus 1. After it you can conclude it. Now we proceed towards next step to write for solving this problem. If you write Pm plus 1, that means 1 square, 3 square plus 5 square plus dot 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 up to n, term, that means 2m minus 1 whole square plus after 2m minus 1, what do we have to write? Simply m is replaced by m plus 1. If you replace m by 2m plus 1, you can write 2 times. I want to write directly because there is no enough space to write it. 2 times m plus 1 minus 1 whole square. M is replaced for writing next term. That means I have written up to m terms, but we have to write also m plus 1 terms because we have to write Pm plus 1. Pm plus 1, that represents sum of a square of odd numbers up to m plus 1 terms. Here I have written m up to m terms, so you have to again add m plus 1 term. That means you can write 2 times m plus 1. Simply in n terms you have to replace m by m plus 1. After writing you can write 2m plus 3, that means 2 minus 1, that means simply 1. That means you can write 2m plus 1 whole square. Now after adding you can show that 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square plus dot 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 2m minus 1 whole square represents m into m 4m square minus 1 divided by 3 according to supposing equation of first. So you can show that m times 4m square minus 1 divided by 3 and m plus 1 term will be 2m plus 1 whole square. Now you have to arrange whole expression. After it you can write 4m square minus 1 square, that means m times 2m plus 1 into 2m minus 1 divided by 3 plus 2m plus 1 whole square. Now if you take common from both terms 2m plus 1, you can write m times 2m minus 1 divided by 3 plus 2m plus 1. You can simply write. Now rough firstly written downward portion, you can write it 2m plus 1 times 2m square minus m 6m plus 3 divided by 3. You can write it as now you have to write again it in above portion. If you write in above portion 2m plus 1 into 2m square plus 5m plus 3 divided by 3. Now you have to again consider what? You have to consider where do we have to reach? Where do you have to reach? Simply
after taking common, after splitting its middle term, what do we get? (2m + 1) (2m²+ 2m + 3m + 3)) = 2m + 1 × if you take common 2m, you get 2m + 1. If you get common 3, you get m plus 1. If you take common 3, you get 3 × m + 1/3 is equal to 2m + 1 × 2m + 3 × m + 1/3. You can write m plus 1 times, in the denominator I have written 3. M plus 1 times 2m + 1 × 2m + 3 / 3. Now I want to ask to you, where do you have to reach? As you know that I have to reach at the m plus 1 times 2m + 1 × 2m + 3 / 3. Firstly, as you know that you have to reach at which point? RHS should be m plus 1 times 4 times m plus 1 whole square minus 1/3. You have to get this expression. How can you get? Simply, as you know that m plus 1 × 2m + 1 × 2m + 3/3. Now you have to, with the help of this expression, you have to go at that point. Or not, if you write in the RHS of given a statement, that means by supposing a statement, that means concluded a statement. If you written it in a concluded statement, then you can simplify it. Then in that case, you feel not bother. Or if you reach at that point, you can write simply that line. That line you can write simply. But in that case, teacher thinks about you, how can you write it? It becomes very difficult line. So you have to firstly learn it. I am trying to reach you at that point. As you know that it we have to reach at that point. You have to also think, how can you get this line? Simply, you have to put n is equal to m plus 1 at the RHS of concluded statement. Concluded statement, that means what? You have to return pm plus 1, 1 square plus 1 square plus 3 square plus 5 square ... 2m - 1 square plus, that means 2m - 1 square plus 2 times m plus 1 - 1 square. That means you have to write, you have to get this expression. Now I have gotten this expression. First, I want to write it. M plus 1 times 2m plus 1 into 2m plus 3 divided by 3. Now you have to multiply both expressions. Then you get m plus 1 into, I have already said you, you have, you can write directly after this line, you can write directly this line. But if a teacher thinks at that point, how a student, students simply can't jump from here to that place. So for explaining, I want to write it. Or not, when you feel not well, you can write directly this statement. Now you can write, if you multiply on both sides, you get 4m² + 6m + 2m + 3/3. M plus 1 into. If you take common, 4m² + 8m + 3/3. That represents m plus 1 times, here you can take common 4. If you take common 4, then you have to write 4 times m² + 2m + 1 - 1. How do you write it? As you know that if you multiply 4m square plus 8m plus 4 minus 1, 4 minus 1, that means 3, and next term will be dnf. Now I have I have rubbed it. M plus 1 into 4 m plus 1 whole square, a square of m plus 1 minus 1 divided by 3. I think I have get concluded a result. That is, it is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. It is also true for n is equal to m plus 1. Understood? Now we take next example. The next problem, it says that prove by mathematical induction 1 square plus 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube dot 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 up to n terms is equal to h. N terms is given. N cube is equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2 completely whole square. How can we prove it? Firstly, now I want to increase our speed. Let Pn is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus dot 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 up to n terms, that can be written as n into n plus 1 divided by 2 square. At n is equal to 1, I want to check correctness. Then you can write p1 is equal to 1 cube, that will be 1 times 1 plus 1 divided by 2 whole square, that represents 1. That means you can say that its LHS and RHS will be same in both cases. So you can say that pn is true for n is equal to 1. Now in second part, if pn is true, if pn is true for n is equal to 1, then suppose let it is also true for n is equal to m. It is also true for n is equal to m. If it is true for n is equal to m, then you can write pm is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus dot 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 m cube is equal to m into m plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. That means let it is also true, it is true for n is equal to m, then you can write 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube dot dot m cube is equal to m into m plus 2 divided by 2 completely whole square. Now, if you have to suppose it equation first. If Pm is true, then what do we have to go? Then what do we have to reach at that point? Then we have to show that. Then you have to show that Pm plus 1 is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus dot 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 m whole cube of m plus 1 is equal to m plus 1 into m plus 1. N is replaced by m plus 1. N is replaced by m plus 1. Then you get m plus 1 times m plus 1 plus 1. That means m plus 2 divided by 2 whole square. You have to prove it. You have to prove it. Or if you want to write in two steps, you can write it as m plus 1 into m plus 1 plus 1 divided by 2 whole square. Now with the help of LHS of pm plus 1, you have to reach at that point. I have written this statement forcefully, not a according to given statement. I have written this statement forcefully. Now you have to reach at that point using LHS. From LHS, you can show that you can take 1 cube, 2 cube plus dot 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 m plus 1 cube. Before it, you have to also write m cube, sorry, I have forgotten, m plus 1 cube, that is up to m cube, from 1 cube, 2 cube, dot 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 m cube, you can write it as m times m plus 1, m times m plus 1. divided by 2 whole square plus, here second term will be m plus 1 1 2 if you take common from bottom m plus 1 whole square after taking common m plus 1 square you get m square by 4 or you can take also common 4 sorry you can't take common 4 m square by 4 plus m plus 1 if you simplify you can write it as m square plus 4m plus 1 sorry 4m plus 4 divided by 4 in LHS you have to also multiply by m plus 1 whole square now you get m plus 1 whole square m plus 1 whole square times m square plus 4m plus 4 you can write it as m plus 1 whole square into m plus 2 whole square divided by 4 you can rewrite it as m plus 1 whole into m plus 2 can be written as m plus 1 divided by 2 whole square with that is required for me so RHS I got that is PM plus 1 is also true so PM is true I think you understand whole problems and how can you prove this type all problems of mathematical induction in the next class I will discuss again some different kind of problem of mathematical induction